Hello, my name is Luna, and you're watching The Luna Show. Right now, you're about to see Kelly Couture. So now you are Kelly Couture.
Yes, I am the legendary overall mother, Kelly Couture, up in the building.
So what made you do couture?
It was, you know, I was a Mizrahi for so many years.
Forever? And, like, yeah. From day one, right?
Yeah, basically.
Were you ever in any other house?
No, I was never in no other house. I wanted to be in another house. Actually, the first house that I wanted to actually be in was the house of St. Clair. But I was still in school at that time, and at that time, Ashley was the Aurora mother of the house of St. Clair. And she told me that I needed to focus on school and finishing schooling before I think about getting in the house. So once I graduated from high school, I didn't want to be a St. Clair anymore. I don't know why. And so I joined the house of Mizrahi. And I was there, and I went to the first house meeting, and it was a split decision between the Butch Queens and the Femme Queens and the Butch Queens and Drags in the house, because they was asking me so many questions. And I told them one day that I was going to be the mother of the house. And so, you know, all the female figures at that time was not having that. So if my sister, the icon, founding CEO of the House of Meekly, Kool-Aid didn't come in, I would have never became a Mizrahi, because she was the deciding vote. And that's how I became a Mizrahi and was a Mizrahi. And I stayed there for many years as the boss lady, and then transitioned into being the New York City mother, and then transitioning over to being the East Coast mother. And then I felt at that time in my life that my it was no need for me there anymore, so I wanted to move on and try something new. And it was a lot of power struggles and everything going on there, and you know, and so I wanted to move on and try something new. So I ventured off with my sister, the icon Jasmine Couture, and became a couture.
So was that an easy transition for you, or?
It's definitely an easy transition. It's definitely an easy transition for anything that I do with myself, because I'm a chameleon. I can adapt with anybody that I'm around or anybody that I can affiliate myself with. And a lot of the girls don't understand that. They just think that I'm just such a bitch, and I'm not.
No, I actually know a soft side of you. Like, I think you're like wonderful, and
yeah, you know,
you're
I'm funny, but
you're fair too.
But the one thing,
and I watched you at the latex ball.
Yes, and it's no shade at the latex ball. Everybody thinks that it's shade about what I did at the latex ball, and like I said on my radio show, it's never shade with anything that I do. And it's no shade. Albert, yes, he was out in the early 90s, but nobody has never officially deemed Albert a legend for him to walk legendary realness. Yes, in all actuality, he is a legend, but nobody officially deems him.
But do you think a couple of people, that happens with a few people?
Yeah, that happens.
There's a couple of people that walked legendary something.
There's a lot of people that have been walking these legendary.
But nobody ever claimed them as legend.
And nobody never claimed them as legend. And this is the problem with the ballroom scene here today. It's a lot of people from...
Well, ballroom is not structured.
Yeah, it's not. But it's a lot of people from back in the days that should be legend. It's an icon. We need to fix that first. Then worry about the new generation and the generation to come. And like I say, the ballroom is just like being a music artist. Everybody is not going to go platinum, just like everybody is not going to go legend. It's no shade. But you know, but it was no shade, and I don't want anybody to think that it was shade. And the whole thing with Little Bit is, I chopped him, yes, the girls might consider
him. Oh, no, but he got through, though, didn't he?
No, he didn't get through. I chopped him, too. I chopped him because he fell out of his dip and everything. And so the girls think it's all types of shade.
But so did the Garcon kid.
And they think it's all types of shade and stuff. I don't have time for all of that. Like, I tell you, when I sit on the judges panel, I'm going to keep it real, and I want the girls to keep it real with
that's,
me.
That's one thing I admire about you. Like, over the years, you know, you don't know this, but I admire you from a distance, because you were always Kelly, and you always truthful, And you're always fair.
And that's the way, and nobody, that's the way it's supposed to be. You're supposed to be
truthful. People cannot hate somebody fair. Who's fair.
And it's no shade. And I said this on one of my posts that I made the other day. If 10 or 15 years down the line from now, I come back out and I'm not what I was today and what I established myself as in the boardroom, I don't want nobody to give me 10s because I'm an icon or I'm a legend or what.
Do you feel
I,
that happens
what
often?
I lived, what I used to do. I want you to judge me for what you see in front of me, and a lot of people and a lot of the commentators.
Yeah, but also as an icon or a legend for something like voguing, for an example, like at the latex ball, sometimes as you get older things aren't the same way, but you're still an icon or a legend.
And
so
I think, and you
what do you think
not,
about that?
And you know it's not the way it used to be back
so
in
you
the
feel
day.
Like you
so
should
I
be treated
you, I think you should just come out there and give the girls a little graceful catwalk. I'm not walking this category, but I'm gonna come out and give a little moment so the girls can know that I'm still here.
Yeah.
Because if you can't keep up
also
with
you
speed,
wouldn't compete if you're a
no,
legend or
no,
an icon.
If I'm a legend or icon back in 15 or 20 years from now, and my face and my realness is not given what it was back in the day, I'm gonna come out there.
But real is real, isn't
I'm
it?
I'm gonna come out there, but you never know. The cheeks might.
I mean, something like
cheeks,
face or.
The cheeks might drop. The lips might. The
no,
lips
but
might go away. You know, you never know. I might have to go see the doctor and get it fixed again.
No, but that's what's interesting about realness. Realness, you could always maintain.
Yeah, you could always maintain realness,
well,
but the face
can. Face you can also, depending.
Yeah, depending on who you are.
But what about performance? You know, the body changes.
Yeah, the body changes.
You
so
can't
I think
do,
the girls need to just sit on the sideline and
okay.
not even do it anymore.
So I'll say this because I used to say this to Laomi all the time. Do you feel like after a while her body's not going to move the same way? And
no, I think if you give, I don't know.
I mean,
know,
even Pony doesn't even move the same
with
way.
With the stamina and everything that she has with her body, I don't know if her body is still going to be able to hold up to all of those tricks and everything in another 10 years.
I mean,
we
it happened to everybody.
We have to, excuse me, I'm sweating. I am over here in the heat.
Oh,
I'm
I can't
sweating.
Tell.
But, you know, you have to, we just have to wait and see. But I don't think that they should still come out if they're not going to give. If you're not going to give the performance that made you legend, I think you should just come out and get the right.
And
I don't
wait.
Want y'all to judge me, but I'm coming out to give a little something for the kids to keep my legacy alive. Don't come out and walk the category if you can't give
so
what,
you,
what made you legend.
So what do you feel about Arbor and Janice when they came out for the latex ball?
Well, I'm going to keep my opinions to myself. I'm going to keep my opinion to myself because, you know, the girls don't think that.
I mean, Albert
I
did
like
what
them.
Albert always did, though.
Yeah, and the girl, you know, the girls don't think I like them, so I'm going to keep my opinion to myself because I don't want the girls to be bashing me on Facebook. They already bashed me already. So I'm going to keep my opinions to myself, honey, you know. But my opinions, you know, I'm going to keep them to myself.
So in terms of performance, what do you think future legends should do? You know what I mean? Like, the new kids.
Like
eventually, they're... Boots is not going to vogue the same way. Justin is not going to vogue. Omari's not going to vogue the same way.
After a while, I think it's...
What do you feel like they need to do?
It's time. You gotta know. You have to know when is the right time...
To stop?
To pass your crown. And let a new girl come through. Because you just can't... You can't be out there anymore. And that's when the girls realize. The girls feel that they can keep... That they're going to keep these crowns forever. And don't know when to pass their crown. And that's what they need to learn.
So what do you think about, what about yourself as a realness person, as a face girl? Do you feel like you get to the point that you don't even need to walk, or how
you know,
do you feel about that?
Right now, when I feel,
because you
feel,
had your heydays when
yeah,
you walked.
Yeah, I feel that it's just like, you know, I come out and I play with the kids from time to time because I remember back in the days when I wasn't a legend and I was just a girl. I come back out and after one of the kids went over me, I tell them, go home and put up on your Facebook, you're a legend slayer. Because baby, that used to be the catchphrase when you slayed a legend back in the day.
But we didn't have Facebook back then.
Yeah, we didn't have Facebook and all
or
that stuff.
Or MySpace.
Yeah, you know, and I used to tell the girls, you know, go on your page and get that you're a legend slayer. You slayed a legend. Because that's what I used to do back in the day. Oh, the girl, a legend slayer. They don't even say that no more. When the new kids back in the days, when you slayed a legend, the next time you came to a ball, they would say legend slayer. They don't even give that to
you. It was interesting because I was looking at the footage from the latex ball with Charles, Khan, Christian, and Cassandra Ebony when they battled. Like, it was interesting to see that contrast. It's like a whole different generation. Cassandra, you know, a new legend today and stuff like that. How do you look at that? Like, when you're judging it and you see somebody like a Charles Christian and a Cassandra, like, obviously Cassandra's going to do things that he can't do, but he did his thing in his day. So what do performance people do?
I look at it like, you know, in the whole aspect of, you know, Charles, his performance is still giving you, it's still giving you that rot, that vibrant life that it gave you back in the days. Uh-huh. It wasn't as fast as Cassandra's, but they both was just as equally talented mm-hmm. that night with their performance. So you can't take nothing from either one of them.
Yeah.
So, you know.
And yeah, I know. Because sometimes they put you up with somebody who's younger.
Yeah. Somebody that's got more stamina than you and stuff.
Do you feel like that when you walk and they put you against somebody and you'll be like, oh my God.
Yeah, whoever they pit me against, what if they win or if I win. It's just, it's all about having fun. In all mm-hmm. actuality.
But a lot of people don't know that.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know that.
And they take it really seriously.
If the one thing the girls should know about me is that it was because of the kids in my house when I was mm-hmm. in Mizrahi, when I was a Couture. It was because of the kids in my house mm-hmm. that make me still want to be a part of the ballroom scene. Because in all actuality, the ballroom scene is not what it was back in the days from the Mark Ballroom and the YWCA and places of that nature where we used to have balls all over the place. It's not the same. It's not fun. Uh-huh. But the kids keep me coming back out to the scene. Mm-hmm. And so that's why I keep coming back out mm-hmm. for my kids.
So what are your plans for Couture? What do you want to do? You want to conquer the world? Well, you're doing that now with your show. Tell me a little bit about your show.
Oh, well, my show is just like, you know, it's off the chain. It's like so many girls have came. You know, I definitely got to give big shout-outs to Tom Blumenthal for definitely coming through and uh-huh. starting Blog Talk and bringing the forefront to the radio. Uh-huh. And, you know, and being the print of Blog Talk. And now I am the blueprint of it because I have been here doing it for 5 years. Uh-huh. And it's a lot of girls that have came and keep coming and coming and trying to do what I do. And what I keep telling them is they can't do what I do because my mouth is so nasty and I don't care what anybody says about me or what opinions they have about me. I'm going to say what's on my mind, and everybody uh-huh. else can't do that. They're so worried about what's going to happen to their kids if they say this or what's going to mm-hmm. I don't worry about that. I don't worry about the backlash.
Do you feel like sometimes you cross the boundary, or do you feel like, you know,
no,
what, it's ballroom, so who cares?
I don't cross the boundary. I'm just a good journalist. Uh-huh. I do what I do because I can do it, bitch.
So who would you compare yourself with a journalist?
As a journalist, I would compare myself with because I can give you Oprah Winfrey, I can give you Wendy Williams, I can give you Ricky Lake, and I can give you Barbara Walters. So I consider myself, on some nights I come on the show and the girls just be gagging that I'm giving you Oprah and Barbara Walters, and my mouth is, my words and my speech uh-huh. is just so out there and articulated, and they like, Kelly, are you high? What's going on? And then some nights I come and I give you Wendy Williams, bitch, and Jerry Springer all uh-huh. at once, because that's just the person I am. I adapt with my environment. I can adapt around the people I'm around.
Tell the viewers how they can hear your show or see your show.
If you want to listen to my show, to everybody out there, anybody across the country, 347-215-6820 or blogtalkradio.com/tens or chops. It's the number one station in ballroom history. It don't get uh-huh. no better than that. Uh-huh.
So what's one message you would like to tell future people about the ballroom scene?
Well, one message I want to tell future people about the ballroom scene: perfect your craft when you come out, and everything doesn't happen overnight. It's a process that you have to go through with your craft and everything that
you
do.
Went through that process.
Yeah, you have to go through it, and when you come out,
you have to find yourself.
When you come out on the floor, you have to be 100% with everything that you do, and these girls need to mm-hmm. stop coming with these half-ass effects, because mm-hmm. that's not going to get you through. Mm-hmm. Your effects and your talent and everything will get you through. A house don't make you, you make the house
make
yourself stronger.
Yeah.
And everybody out there, my last closing statement is vote or die. Register to vote. We need Obama in the office for another 4 years.
Yes.
Vote for Obama and let's keep it in the office. Obama, 2012, 4 more years, President Obama.
Yes.
couture out.
Okay, I know you wanted to close with that, but I want to ask you one last question.
Yeah.
Laomi, is she a couture or what she's doing?
Laomi is just Laomi. She's doing her own thing.
Uh-huh. And, so you're her mother, right?
I'm gonna always be her mother, and so, I'm gonna always be my mother. That's one thing about me. Me and my children, whether they're in my house or they're in another house or they wasn't.
See,
my
but
house,
a lot of people don't know house, that.
We're gonna always have a personal relationship, just like myself and Jasmine. Our relationship is bigger than a house. Our relationship is bigger than ballroom. If I decided to leave couture today or tomorrow, me and Jasmine is gonna always be sisters because our relationship is not built around houses. And a lot of people relationships is built. A lot of people relationships and friendship is built around houses. And when they leave the house, that's how their friendship and their relationship build up. It was never an actual friendship or relationship or sisterhood, because, you know.
Well, but then you have people who are sisters in the name of love, but then they surprisingly tell you they're in a new house.
And then they're in a new house, and then they're not sisters anymore, and the girls is reading and then everything. She was never really your sister to begin with in the beginning.
Is that how you feel about it?
Yeah, that's how I feel about it.
Okay, so.
Because if you're my sister, and you're my friend, and you're my family member, and we consider ourselves family, regardless to what last name that we have, we still should be family. Mm-hmm. It's just like a marriage. We can all be couture's, okay? But at the end of the day, I'm going to go marry him, and I'm going to be a prodigy. So my new last name is going to be prodigy, but in all actuality, my blood is still here.
Yeah.
So we should still be family at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. A lot of the girls don't see it that way.
So tell me this. You were blonde at the latex. Are you giving us an eye look right now?
Yeah, I was blonde at the latex, and now I'm 27-4 tonight. And I don't know what color I'll be this weekend in Prodigy Weekend. I don't know what color I'll be next weekend in Atlanta. You know, I like to switch
you'll be
it
at
out.
Prodigy Weekend.
Yeah, I'll be at Prodigy Weekend this weekend.
Are you judging or walking?
I'll be judging this weekend.
Yay.
So, you know, I don't know what look I'm going to be doing, but one thing about me
you should do red.
One thing about me red. Is that I never keep the same look. I always gotta change it up with the girls. That's one thing. And if the red look, it's coming really soon.
Yeah, I can see you in red. You look.
Yeah, I'm gonna be in red. I'm gonna be in my red dude really soon.
All right. Well, thank you.
Thank you. Don't forget October 27th, Washington D.C. Gaga Ween 666. My legendary icon sister presents Gaga Ween. She has $2,000 runway categories, $1,000 realness category, $1,000 face category. It's going down in Washington D.C. Girls, hit her up on Facebook.
That's for Halloween.
Yeah. So it's on the 27th for October. In Washington, D.C. Hit her up at Jasmine at www.facebook.com/JasmineCouture Collections or Gagaween. I don't know which one it is, but it's one of them. Hit her up. It's going down.
All right. Well, thank you.
Thank you.